Hit boy. First, I want to give a shout out to everybody at Children's Mercy Hospital in Kansas City, Missouri. Hi, Chad, and all your friends, and everybody else who watches JB up there. I also want to say hi to Paul up there in Canada, Ottawa, I think it is, Cuts 777, Paper Cuts 777, for sending me a bunch of fans and mentioning me in videos, and I'm mentioning you now, boy. Can you see that? Is the camera working? Let me see. Yeah, it's working, boy. Oh, I want to thank everybody for all of the comments on the videos. Y'all keep commenting. I love reading them. I'll reply to every one of them. Somebody wrote in and said I'm using this lemon press wrong. Boy, the instructions said to put the flesh of the lemon down with the looking at the backside of the lemon up, and then it gets all the juice out. It came with instructions. I read them. Always read the directions. You was wrong. I'm sorry. Fail. What are we doing? We getting ready to go to the damn beach is what we're doing. It's a last minute trip. We going down to Fort Morgan, Alabama, which is right there close to Gulf Shores, close to the Florida state line. And what I'm doing is making some meatballs that I'm going to freeze, because they freeze well. And I'm going to cook them first and freeze them. And we're going to make a big spaghetti when we get down there. So this is going to be to be continued once we get down to the damn beach house. What I did is I peeled up a whole lot of garlic. And we're going to crush that. We got some hamburger buns in there. And I done wetted them down with one can of evaporated milk. Come on, Buck, you non-union son of a bitch. And it ain't got quite enough milk in it. So we're going to wet them down with a little bit more. And I got a bunch of green onions over here peeled up. Not a bunch, but almost a whole bunch. By and by the bunch. Boy. I mixed up some salt, pepper, basil, oregano, a little bit of parsley in here. And I'm making a lot because we're going to have about 10 people. The meatballs love seasoning. You got to season them up right. So we're going to dump some of this salt and pepper mixture in here. Got some Parmesan cheese. And they grind this fresh at the grocery store that I go to. And we're going to put about that much in there. Now we need to go ahead and crush this garlic up. I'm going to use my garlic press too to do that with. Now here's the only thing I don't like about using the garlic press, and this is a good one. This is made by Chef Mate. It's good and heavy, but see, there's a lot of stuff that don't press through. This is the fiber part of the garlic. So what do? Well, if I was making the spaghetti right now, I'd put all that in there, but I ain't. So we're going to take this and put it in our mortar and pestle and grind it up and get it in them damn meatballs. If you don't like garlic, you better not do that. All right, I got some 1815 ground round. Usually I like to use chuck. Make sure you get that plastic off your finger, boy. Usually I like to use chuck, but it'd be all right. We're going to use this. This is one half of the meatballs. How many pounds was that, JB? 2.75, looks like. All right? I'm going to get this all mixed up, make some balls, and then we're going to pour this in there with the second pack and make some more balls. We're going to have to do it in two steps. Rocket science. Alright, now while you're making meatballs, if you keep your hands wet, the meat won't stick to them.
I'll keep them greased, one.
I also noticed a bunch of y'all been asking questions about why don't you make this, why don't you make that. Pay attention over here. Look, we making meatballs. Why don't y'all search JB's channel, and if you look on my main page, it'll show you how to search JB's channel. That's the main featured video of what you're asking about. Keep in mind, I may have not spelt it right, so use alternate spellings if you don't come up with anything. If you're looking for alligator or fried chicken, no, ain't never done that. If you're looking for fried fish, I don't think I've done that either. I don't like alligator. I don't like deer. Keep your hands wet, boy. So try to make these equal. This would make a fine meatloaf too, yeah, boy. Oh, I don't know who come up with the idea of putting oatmeal in a meatloaf. That's about ridiculous. You don't do that kind of shit. The hell? That's horse food. Feed it to your horse. Alright, so I'm gonna go ahead and finish making these meatballs. And, look, pay attention. I use the back of my hand to touch my camera. You don't use what's been in the food. I've seen this recipe where they take freshwater mozzarella and stuff it up inside the meatballs and then cook them like that. I'm going to have to try that one time. Not this time. I also got a recipe for what's called Cajun bouillettes. And I've uploaded it. I don't know if I spelt it right. You may have to try alternate spellings. But it's meatballs with one whole toe of garlic in each meatball. And you cook them or fry them and make a brown gravy with them and eat them over rice and have some kind of beans or fiber or something like that. All right. First batch done. Let's get the second batch done. Meatballs in. Convection roast. Center him up, JB. I forgot to show y'all this. This is a singing bowl. Watch. Side tonight, boy. Okay. Took it over there in the sink and wash the son of a bitch. Hey, boy. Let's go ahead and finish this video that I started at the house with Chad Rosenthal from Mercy General Children's Hospital. I don't know. This year is what we're going to do. We're going to peel up these bell peppers, these onions, and make us a tomato sauce. We got wine, made a paste, mushrooms, and this stuff you see right there, boy. Just pay attention. We at the beach. Beach cooking at its finest. Also brought some Savannah sausage down here with us, some smoked. Mild pork sausage, that's going in the spaghetti sauce too. Chop up in little curry coins. Now in the pot A, we're going to put some EVOO. And some dice up onion. We got to dice up another one, and we got to dice in bell peppers. And get all that in there, boy. So let me get done. All right, boy, so I got one bell pepper chop up. It going in there. I got to chop up another one after I go wrench it in the zinc.
It's the noisiest non-union dishwasher I ever heard in my life. And it's a Roper brand. All right, so we got this sausage over here. Let's go ahead and put that in the oven. 350 and cook it till we get some grease out of it. Brand new oven too. I like that. Now I got a can right here that I done mauled open. There's a can opener that's down here at the bitch beach. Don't worry where the shit. I'm gonna stir them in there. The mushrooms with the onions. Look in there, boy. See? The mushrooms, the onions, the bell peppers. Alright? We'll give them a little bit of time, then we're gonna put some garlic in here. I just put a whole can of tomato paste in there. And beat the hell out of the damn can too. Got some garlic cloves. Got a meat hammer. Use the smooth side. Crushed garlic. How about that? Instant. Yum. Garlic. Going in there. All of y'all going in there. With the tomato paste and everything else, we'll stir that around. Now watch. Some wine. Cabernet Sauvignon. Use Chianti if you can get it. We get it down here. This is just easy. Cheaper. Works just the same. Chianti's a little bit sweeter, but we don't need that sweetness because we're going to use Italian style stewed tomatoes and they sweet. Boy! Alright. I done decided looking at this. Got a ton of meatballs got to go in there. Got a lot of sausage. Go ahead and dump the rest of this bottle of wine in there. Now I don't got to bring it home. Go to the waste can. We'll cook it off. Give it a better flavor. Cook, boy. Go ahead and put some Italian style stewed tomatoes in here with that juice. Got two cans of them. All going in there. I almost forgot. We need to add some oregano, some parsley. And some basil. Come on, Basil. Where you at, boy? Damn, I ain't bring it. I did too bring it. It's just in another cap. Some basil. Now, we done. Stir it up. All right. You stir, look. Stir some bit. Now. Making a Cajun pasta sauce. Let's check on that sausage. It is spanking brand new oven. Oh yeah, it's looking good, huh? Go back in there, boy. Sauce going in. Oh, love it.
Two cans.
You got V8? You can use that in here too? Yeah, boy. Worked just fine. Non-union can opener. I had to bust this sumbitch open with my hatchet. My little axe that I brought. See, super geniuses think about all that kind of shit. Yeah, boy. I just chopped up all that smoked sausage and put it in there. And I put the meatballs in there too. See, they way up underneath. See that one? Go sink down in there. So the meatballs that I froze and brought to the beach. How about that? I melted some butter on top of some garlic bread and poured it on there like that. Now we're gonna go bake that off in the oven and warm it up. Now, done. All right, hot water boiling. And turn it up, boy. No. High is this way. I ain't used to the stove yet. So, the water boiling. We're gonna put a couple packs of pasta in there. Everybody go in there and be happy. Now, we got little dogs and found them a sand crab and they messing with it. Sand crab done nipped them on the nose a couple times. I don't know what they think they're gonna do once they catch it. Sand crab gonna tear his little ass up. So the wind done calmed down a lot. Still got a lot of surf. That's real cool. And here's JB down at the beach. Sorry. The beachy. And we ought to drink some more pops with foam on tops. Just check it all out.